Hey guys, no intro this time. I am going to go straight to it. So make sure your machine has Catalina on it, whether it be DOSDUDE's patcher or if it's native, or somehow just get Catalina on your machine first. It is recommended you do this first before you get Big Sur. For me, I am running DOSDUDE's patcher on my 5.1 Mac Pro, and we're going to start from there. Oh, and also, for the requirements of this video, you need to have an external USB that is 16 gigabytes or higher, and an external USB keyboard for desktop users. And for Mac Pro users, it is recommended that you have your original Mac Pro graphics card with you. Now, all you need to do is head over to BenSova's patcher, and it is a USB patcher, and unfortunately, DOSDUDE didn't make a Big Sur patcher this time because he has a lot going wrong and he has a couple of things and heavy projects to do. So instead, we decided to use BenSova for now, and there is Barry Khan's patcher, but I think BenSova's is actually a much more simple one. So he even has the instructions down for us right here for us to follow, and see, it's pretty simple here, and all you need is just a USB drive that's 16 gigabytes or over. You could possibly do with 8, but I recommend 16. So we're going to go through the supported Macs list, and down here, as you could see, most of the 5.1s do work. Partially supported Macs are down there, but 2009, if you flash it to a 5.1, it should be fine. The MacBook Pro 2012, we are going to have Wi-Fi issues, so but we are going to go and fix that later on in the future. So down here, anything that doesn't have a metal graphics acceleration is going to have problems with this patcher. Now, it is recommended that you use a metal graphics card. Without one, the user experience will be very unstable and unusable. But I will put a link down so you can see what your choices are for your compatibility, of course. So we're going to go through right here to the releases, and we're going to download these two files, which is the post install and the patch sur DMG. First of all, we're going to use the patch sur DMG to install Big Sur onto our USB. And we're going to use the post install for after, and after we get Big Sur, of course. So what we're going to do is right click and open this package, and click on start. Now this is version 3 now, and everything should be a lot better. By the time this video is out, Big Sur should be already be released. Just gonna go through a set of instructions here. Feel free to read this in your own time. For you, I would try with release because that is the most stable one out of here. Now there isn't a point of using public beta or the regular beta, so we're just gonna go with the regular release. From here, you can pick from update and clean. Unfortunately, right now, the only option we have here is update, so we're gonna click that one. Right now, it's gonna download the files. This part wouldn't take too long, so I'd say only about 2 minutes. Now we're at the download install a system package. Now, I have already downloaded the files here, but for you guys, you need to click the blue button. Which right now is highlighted green. You can look for other versions, but it is advised that you pick the recent one, which is the one that I have already got down, which is macOS 11.1. And click the one at the very top, and then go on, click it once more, and go and hit start. Now you are prompted to enter your password for your account, and just chuck your password in. And now installing the files will take a bit, and we're talking about at least about half an hour, which it took me. I think it all depends on the internet speed, but after that you should be prompted to this page. Since I have a lot of drives inside my Mac Pro, what you're gonna need to do is rename your USB flash drive to the closest thing you can see in the middle. So for this example, mine is a Seagate iWolf, so rename it to something that's similar or close enough to that, so you can actually click on that, and then you click the refresh button and then press continue. In my case, I just typed in Seagate Iron Wolf, which it's pretty close to the see. Right there, you can click on that's my USB flash drive. Now click erase. make sure that this is a clean USB and nothing is in there. Now, the installation will take a while, again, for everything to be patched over to your USB drive, which will take another half an hour for in my case, so I'm going to jump straight to the finish part, and now we can move to the hardware side. Now, Mac Pro users, listen up, you're going to need to grab yourself an original graphics card. The one that you can actually see your boot volume when holding Alt option. Now, if you already have OpenCore installed, I suppose you can use the bootloader from there. I don't see why. I haven't tried this method, but I don't see it wouldn't be any different. Now, once you're at the bootloader screen, now remember to pick EFI boot, not install macOS Big Sur, because the USB hasn't been fully patched yet, if you want to say that. It's been patched, but we gotta do one more thing, of course. Once you hit EFI boot, your machine should shut down. That's perfectly fine. Now go ahead and reboot it back up, and remember to hold Option and so you can see the boot picker screen again. Once there, now this time go and hit install macOS Big Sur. Now the installation process should be normal. Now this will take a while. It took me about 5 minutes from to get this to the installation screen. Once here, you want to go and click on install macOS Big Sur up here. And then click continue. Now this, don't worry, this won't wipe your drive and your main drive. And it will just patch over the new update. Now go and select a drive that you want to put Big Sur on. I'm going to choose my main drive because, I'm pretty brave to do so. From here, it should just install like normal, so you're just going to wait like a normal update. Now, before it loads all the way to the end, your screen will go black. Now, this is perfectly normal, and do not panic. Just leave it as it is, and it should turn on back normally. Now from here, don't do anything, just leave it as it is installing. Your screen will go off and on again 3 times. After that, it should load straight into the login screen. Now from here, just log in as normal, chuck your password in. Now we're just gonna wait for the UI to pop up. Now I'm pretty sure that this part is something to do with the VRAM and obviously with the regular graphics card, everything's gonna be so slow. This is why I recommend you guys to get a metal supported graphics card that can actually handle Big Sur. Now, we're not done yet. Remember that we downloaded Patch Sur previously? The other file, of course. Now we're gonna launch it and download the KEX files so that we can have the files for the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth modules and everything else just to get the machine working and running. Go ahead and chuck in your password. Wait a while for the machine to patch the KEX. After that, just click restart to finish. Okay, now we're back at the logging screen. Mac Pro users, you can now shut down your machine and chuck in your regular graphics card. Okay, just popped in my regular graphics card back in. Now everything is back to normal. Just gonna log in now. Sorry about the camera angle here and the lighting. As you see on the top right, you can see the Wi-Fi symbol is going back on now and it's all working. Now if you go to the About This Mac section, you should see that your machine is patched to Big Sur, running a full release. Now everything is here, you can actually change the wallpapers to the official Big Sur ones. I personally like this one, but you guys can have your own preferences, so you can pick whatever. Now go on, enjoy your machine with the latest macOS update, and hopefully you guys actually enjoyed the tutorial. I guess I'll see you guys next time. Ciao!